Well, as a kid, I remember seeing the original film, and it was one of my favourite films. And I put films like Mysterious Island and Seven Voyages of Sinbad and Jason the Argonauts and all those films down to the reason I'm directing movies. So when the project to do a remake of the Jules Verne novel came up, I just jumped at it. I mean, it's basically a boyhood dream to do this. It's funny, Mysterious Island in the novel is actually quite mysterious because you don't quite know where it's located. We've located our Mysterious Island somewhere in the South Pacific, you know, thousands of miles from America, but an unknown island. We chose Thailand. With our helpful rower here, we didn't row all the way here, but we chose Thailand to film the movie, and we're down in the southern Thailand here, very tropical, very humid, extraordinary locations. I mean, you walk into some of these caves that we're filming in at the moment, where the Nautilus sits in this lagoon in this limestone cave with all these stalactites or whatever, and it looks like a CGI set in Hollywood or something, and it's like, but it's real. It's just breathtaking. My favourite moment so far is probably Friday afternoon when I get to go home. No, actually, you hear my voice. I mean, we've just finished the spider sequence, which I think is a good creepy scene, because I've always wanted to do. When you say giant spider, everyone goes like they think of, you know, like the old 50s. Tarantula movie. See, it's getting really dark now. This is not quite a spider cave. This is Captain Nemo's Nautilus cave, I don't know. Spotty crap. Our giant spiders aren't like that. I always, as a kid, I wrote a script about a giant spider. Our giant spiders are really only sort of, you know, the size of a big dog. Maybe a little bigger than that, but that's, to me, that's creepier because they can still pounce on you and knock you to the ground. So they're really big, but they're not like stupidly big. But then actually, Jason, there's one sequence where Jason, who plays a character called Pencroft, who's this really sort of like devilish character, I wanted he's found this gold, and I wanted the spider to come over the gold. And I said, the spider's too big to hide behind the chest. He said, well, why don't I have a little spider, which is about the size of my hand, which is probably still a bigger spider than anything in the world. But you have this little spider sort of coming over, and he goes up and he swats it. He says, get off my gold, and swats it. And it'll sound like a little mouse going, yep. And so within a sort of rather horrifying scene, we've sort of managed to sort of combine humour. So in the film Mysterious Island, I think there's a combination of action, adventure, there's romance, there's some funny moments, there's some creepy moments. And I hate just to use that expression, we've thrown the kitchen sink in, but I mean, this sort of genre allows you to be adventurous and just sit down, have a good time. For people who love fantasy genre, I think this is a film for them. It's also a family film. I think it has a lot of appeal. Hopefully, it'll have a lot of appeal for the various groups.
All fans,
yes.
It's a great story.
That is the thing about the film. It is just a great, great story. And a lot goes on. It doesn't stop. I think as soon as the opening credits, you're on this wonderful roller coaster ride, which will lead you into many strange worlds and adventures.